guys, this is Bully. Today, I am going to show you guys how to scan and block cookies using the free version of the GDPR Cookie Consent plugin in your WooCommerce or WordPress website. This is part two of the tutorial that I made about using the GDPR Cookie Consent plugin, but I didn't include the most important features in that tutorial, which is how to scan and block cookies. So I added the link to that video in the description box below and at the end of this video for you guys to check out. But before we get started, I want to welcome back all my subscribers. I appreciate you all and thank you so much for your support. All right, with that being said, let's get started. All right, let's take a look at the cookie scanner feature. Let's go to our demo store, assuming that you already installed the GDPR Cookie Consent plugin by WebToffee. You could click the settings link right there or just go to the left panel to click on the GDPR Cookie Consent. Click Cookie Scanner tab right there. And we need to create an account with Cookie Yes. If you haven't had an account with them yet, so we could scan cookies from our website, click the Connect and Scan button located on the right side. Enter your email address right here. Once done, click the Connect button. This way, you will create an account with them automatically. Once you get this message, you need to go check your email. Let's go check my mailbox. Click verify and get started to verify your email address. The email address has been verified successfully. Let's close out that box. You should be able to see this on your screen. That means it's connected to the Cookie Yes account. And then click the button called Scan Website for Cookies. You should be able to get this message after you click the button. This scanning will take a while. Next, let's check on the cookie scanner result. There it is. It took about 5 hours for it to completely scan my demo website. Your website may take longer. It depends on the speed and the size of your website. All right, let's go back to the demo store and close out that box. Refresh the page to see the result. Here it is. There are no cookies from my demo store at all. By the way, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet and turn on that notification bell so you won't miss any future uploads about e-commerce web designs from me. All right, but if you have some cookies, you could use the list as a guide to block them in the script blocker feature right here. But there are only 4 cookie blockers in the free version of this plugin. If you have some other cookies that are not listed here in the free version, you may have to upgrade to the premium version because there are about 19 cookie blockers. And you could add a custom one to the list as well for the premium version. Once you see the cookie you want to block here, just click the green enable button to block it and select a category from the drop-down box right next to it. Then it will be saved automatically for you. You could check out the free version and the premium version features by going to the settings. Click the free VS Pro tab to see the list of different features. For the free version, you can scan some cookies up to 100 URLs only. But for the premium version, you could scan more than that, over 2,000. You could go through all the lists right here or just go to their website directly just to read more about this plugin. As for the price, based on their website, it looks like it's about $69 a year for a single site where you could get a license, a year of plugin updates, and a year of ticket support. If you see another package is for 5 size and a third package is for 25 size with different prices. So you could check it out by going to their website if you are interested. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful somehow so you can help other people to find my content too. I would appreciate your support a lot. Thank you! Next, let's check out the script blocker feature. Again, for the demo store, click script blocker on the left panel under the plugin. These are the free script blockers for the free version. Right now, I have the Twitter feed enabled, so my demo store should block the Twitter feed automatically. Let's go to the front end right here and let's click the manage consent. As of right now, it still cached my personal data of my cookie settings, actually. But well, here's how you check it. Right click and select inspect. And this is the inspect element tool. Let's put the bar underneath the page. Let's close out that box. Click application tab right here. You should be able to see the cookies on the left, and let's expand that. You should be able to see the list of all the cookies that this website or your website has, and select one of them to see how it looks like. This one doesn't have any cookie names, and there are many values here like name, value, domain, path, and so on. And it looks like Google has a lot of cookies or some of them here. And let's click on Doodling Web Designs. Actually, this is the Doodling Web Design website. It's not my demo store anymore because my demo store doesn't have a lot of cookies, so I have to use this website for demo purposes only. Okay, at least this one has some cookies. Right here, you could see the cookie policy is enabled. It says yes, because I already clicked the accept button and it still cached that information for about 11 months. That's the settings that I set up long ago. As you could see, the value is yes. That means you already agree to that cookie policy. And you could scroll down a little bit more and then you will see like that one, it has the value yes. By the way, if you want to support my channel, I add all the links in the description box below. Thank you so much for your support. All right, let's get back to the video. All right, let's delete some cookies manually as a user. Open a website you want to block cookies from. Right click, select inspect. Click application. And select cookies on the left panel. Make sure you expand the cookies. Click filter on top and type any cookie names right there and you will see the search result right there. You just double click on that cookie and could rename the cookie, and then it will be selected automatically as a red highlight as you could see on the screen. And then if you want to delete this cookie, click the X icon on the top right there. Delete selected cookie. And it's gone. Yep, it's gone. And then if you want to delete all the cookies right here, you don't have to select any of them. Just go to the hamburger icon right there to clear all cookies. Just click it and then all the cookies are gone. That's how we delete cookies manually as a user. If you don't want a third-party website to track your web serving behavior, usage, and preferences without relying on using the cookie consent feature, but it could take some time to remove all the cookies manually though. That's all for today's tutorial. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below of using this plugin to scan and block cookies from your WordPress website or blog, and would love to share them with our community. I would love to hear about them. All right, you guys have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you in my next video. Bye now.